Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this quick video, we'll be showing you how to install the latest version of Java on a Raspberry Pi. Java is a popular programming language that requires a runtime environment for it to operate. Raspberry Pi OS actually typically includes a version of the Java runtime environment, but it's usually significantly out of date. For example, with Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm, you can only install Java 17 by default, even though the latest version is Java 24. While this might be fine for a few cases, some software such as the Minecraft server requires the newer versions of Java. Luckily, we can work around this by adding a third-party repository that builds these newer versions of Java for ARM systems like ours. There's one catch to using this repository, and that is you must be running a 64-bit operating system. For this particular guide, we'll be running Raspberry Pi OS Bookworm 64-bit edition. This should work for any other 64-bit Debian-based operating system that can run on a Raspberry Pi. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi. Now, before we begin to install the Java runtime environment to our Pi, we'll want to update the package list cache by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the package list has finished updating, upgrade any out-of-date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade hyphen y and then pressing enter. We now need to install the software that we need to set up the Azul Java repository on our Raspberry Pi. We can install these by typing in sudo apt install kel gnu pg ca hyphen certificates and then hyphen y and then press enter. These packages are typically pre-installed with Raspberry Pi OS, but we should just make sure so we don't run into issues later. Our next step is to add the Azul repository to our Raspberry Pi. Azul is a company that has a focus on Java development and also happens to provide a repository that provides newer versions of Java. Before we can add the repository itself, we will need to install the GPG key to our Raspberry Pi. This key is essentially used to verify the packages we are downloading did in fact come from this repository. Add this key to your system by typing in kel hyphen s https colon forward slash /azul-repo.key /pipe symbol /sudos /gpg /-hyphen-darma /-o /user/share/keyrings/azul.gpg and then press enter. With the key now saved to our system, we can add the repository itself to our sources by typing in echo space double quote deb space open square bracket arch equals arm 64 space signed hyphen by equal sign /user/share/keyrings/azul.gpg close square bracket space https colon /repos.azul.com/zulu/deb/stable/main:/pipe symbol/sudo/t/etc/apt/sources.list.d/zulu.list and then press enter. As we have made changes to the available sources, we will need to run an update again by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. Once the update completes, you'll now be able to install newer versions of Java onto your Raspberry Pi. If you want to check what versions are available from the Azul repository, type in sudo apt search zulu and then the asterisk symbol and then press enter. This will show you a giant list, but scroll up a little and you'll be able to see the different versions of Java that you are now able to install. You should also have access to the latest versions of Java, as well as some older versions such as Java 8. For this example, we'll be using this repository to install Java 21 onto our Raspberry Pi. It's the same version of Java that is required by the Minecraft server to run. To install this version of Java, type in sudo apt install zulu21-jdk-headless-y and then press enter. You can verify that you've now installed a new version of Java onto your Raspberry Pi by typing in java-version and then pressing enter. With the response from this command, we can see that we successfully installed Java 21 onto our Raspberry Pi. If you found this guide to be helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more content. Until next time, have a good one.